this is the DJI 360 drone. Look at that, DJI, DJI. I know, not officially created by DJI, it's actually modified by us. In the past 10 years, this is a setup we use, just not a DJI camera, we use the Insta camera. So, if you saw that video, my review of the Antigravity A1, by the way, amazing drone. I'm so looking forward for actually get a unit to test it out, everything. But there's one major design issue that probably pretty hard to solve by Antigravity. They're working on it, but probably hard. It's because I thought they would have three cameras, like one on top, one on the bottom, and one in the front to really like stitch out the wobble stitch out in the middle when you fly. Again, like the drone flying forward, the most important subject you capture is in front of the camera, but that is in the stitch line. So you see like a lot of like reframe video, even reframe video, you saw some wobble problem on the front. But for 360, you can't hide those. You can't reframe it out the front. You have to like capture full 360. So that had to be removed. So let's hope Antigravity can fix that with a software solution. But I think they really need three cameras to capture a full 360 sphere. But hey, we already have a ready-to-go solution from DJI. DJI 360 camera, DJI drone, Stabilization right here. Boom. So today, we're gonna test that. Again, like we haven't tested yet to fly the OSMO 360 on the air to see how good is the anti-machine vibration stabilization of this thing. Before that, we actually use the X5 to capture that. So today, we're gonna do a side-by-side comparison between the X5 and the OSMO 260. Other thing is, when we review this camera, the X5 doesn't have a latest firmware, but after my review, release, right, X5 have a major summer firmware update, really increase the image quality. So on the internet, the yard means like, yo, Hugh, you are not using the latest firmware. It's not fair. True, you got it all true, right? So now we don't have the white version. We just don't have it, right? We are not big enough influencer. So we have the old X5, so the same camera. And on the latest firmware, everything the latest, right? And then we gotta compare image quality side by side between the X5 and the OSMO 360. In the air, let's take a look. So the DJI OSMO 360 also has a very solid vibration stabilization. You don't see any jitter, and the horizon line stay pretty straight. Compared to installed 360 X5 on the right, both are really good on a drone. The OSMO 360 does has a slight edge in handling and less of that pendulum effect, simply because it's lighter with a smaller size. The real test though is when you send the drone straight up. Even on a pretty windy day like today, both camera handling really well. I'm sure on a lightweight drone like the Antigravity A1 would have a tough time going straight up 100 meters in the sky in that condition. While we at it, let's look at the image quality, because with 360 drones, it is all about the horizon landscape. The Insta360 does show a visible image quality improvement thanks to its latest firmware update, and that is the beauty of competition. It's great for us as consumer. DJI entering the market pushed pressure on Insta360 to keep pushing image quality forward. That said, when it comes to color, the OSMO 360's 10-bit capture still has a clear advantage over adaptive tone. Look at that distant green tree in the X5, they all kind of blend together. On the OSMO 360, you still get that lush green and really nice object separation. Now, one thing that does concern me, and many influencers has pointed out as well, the aliasing issue right here. This comes from stitching artifacts in DJI Studio. It is not really visible in the original fisheye, so hopefully DJI can improve their software and stitching algorithm. Where the OSMO 360 shine though is high frame rate capture in 8K. Shooting at 50 frames per second mean I can slow down fast motion, like Kimchi running right here. For drone application, that's actually a big deal. That said, for most consumer or casual user, I would still recommend the Antigravity A1 over this wild DJI setup. The OSMO 360 drone rig is heavy. You would definitely need a license to fly it, and it takes a lot more practice compared to the Antigravity A1 simply touch and go design. Plus, it is much more expensive, even if we don't yet know the final retail price of the Antigravity A1. But here's one final advantage DJI has. This 360 drone is available right now, and the Antigravity, we will have to wait until the end of the year.
Okay, so this, what you just saw, is the DJI OSMO 360 on the DJI drone, a fully DJI 360 drone setup. Again, not made by DJI, like nothing to do with DJI. We make that, and it's fun to fly. And again, let me know what you think, actually, guys. I really hope like this video will give a really good benchmark so anti-gravity can really fix their problem. I mean, it's already a really great drone, but you think I really like fix that gyro problem, and that will make a lot of 360 filmmakers very happy to use this drone to capture immersive 360 video for Apple Vision Pro or Meta Quest 3. Yeah, so see you guys in the next video. Ciao.